Hello everyone, an architect by profession, qualified Vastu consultant, an astrologer, a yoga practitioner and a teacher, all in one. That is Aparna Mutneja for you. In my mind, an astrologer is someone who is like above 50 or even older. And yeah, seriously, like whoever I've come across, they are all really, really old. And Vastu has been how do I even say that? Controversial one bordering on superstition. So I was really, really surprised when I came across your profile. So how did you even get into this?
I'm a qualified architect. And while I was practicing as an architect, I had a lot of queries where people wanted to get Vastu done to their houses, hospitals, big, big buildings, and which is what initially got me interested into it. So that's what I was studying. And astrology and Vastu are very related. I sort of had to study astrology to study Vastu further.
To a layman, how would you explain what is Vastu?
Okay. Vastu is basically tuning your environment around you to help you reach your 100% potential. Putting it in a very simple line. Vastu was the ancient Indian knowledge of designing houses, right? What they did was not just the basic architecture we do. They also played with energies. They understood the movement of the sun better, the energies within the earth, which science is still finding out a lot of those. Some of them we know, some of them we don't. So the ancient Indians already had that knowledge. And so that's what the architects at that time used to do. And they were the original architects, Vastu consultants.
I know astrology is a science based on all the planets and planetary positions. Is Vastu also legit science?
Yes, absolutely. So just, you know, like I told you, like a basic thing that it takes into account the solar energy, the land energy. I don't know if you've heard of the Hartmann grid or the Curry grid. There's recently a lot of research by, and Curry is, I think, an American scientist, and Hartmann is a German scientist. And what they realized was that the Earth, throughout the Earth, there are grid lines 2 meters apart of energy. Mm. Get it? And so horizontally and vertically, right? So the node where the horizontal and vertical line connect produces a very, very strong energy. And what they noticed was that if there is a person living on a node like this, basically the energy levels are so high that the human body starts getting sick. And most cases of cancer were found to be living, the house was here, or the one person who had cancer was sleeping on this kind of a node, this grid. It's called the Hartmann grid, and the Curry is a different scientist. He also did the same research, and his grid is called the Curry grid. So it is these small energies which science is just thinking about, like realizing it. And all of these have already been documented in the ancient Vedas, where they talk about all of these. So a lot of times in these cases, when we start studying, sometimes we even have to see this, you know, is this person, if we shift his bed, does he start getting better? Yeah. So like I said, it is very scientific. It is alleged science. And to explain to you, Vastu basically works on your subconscious mind. Talking about it scientifically speaking, everything around you affects you, your surroundings, the way you place your bed, what area of your house you're in. See, when the sun comes up in the east, that's the area of the strong energy, right? That's what they used to say, be in the east early morning. And women used to cook their food between 9 to 12 in the morning. That's the time when the sun is going from the east to the southeast. And that's why they say, put your kitchen in the southeast, right? A lot of people, that's like a very traditional thing to say, put your kitchen in the southeast. That's a Vastu thing. So basically, it was very scientifically done. And when it comes to astrology, every planet has radiation, vibration, rays, as we would call it. And these rays affect our mind. They affect every living thing on the planet, whether it's a human being or an animal. And the way these rays affect you is also really, really affects the way you behave, right? Like we say, whatever's going on in our mind is what how we behave, how we create the world around us. So yeah, it's basically a science to study everything that's affecting you. Astrology is studying the rays of the planets that are affecting you. Vastu is your house, the earth energies, solar energies, everything that's affecting you.
How is it related to Feng Shui? That is different or...
No, actually, now people say it's different, but the rules are very, very similar. Land energy, sun energy, they're the same for China and for us, right? And I think in ancient times, India and China had a strong connection. People were traveling. There were monks, saints traveling through and through. So a lot of, in fact, some I've heard, I believe some forms of martial arts were actually invented in India, even though they're considered part of the Chinese tradition, but those were actually invented in South India, Kerala, I believe. So there's been a mix of knowledge, culture, connections throughout history between India and China. So the rules of Feng Shui and Vastu in my study are pretty much the same. However, in time nowadays, modern times, yeah, if you search the internet, everything is different. What Vastu says, Feng Shui will contradict, but the original knowledge was absolutely the same. They're very similar sciences.
So is Vastu really important for our house?
Yeah, absolutely. I feel like everybody should have a Vastu. Okay, just giving you an example. If you're putting too much energy into something, your career, like for example, you're trying to get there, you're trying to get there, and there's always something blocking you. It's not happening. There's some blockage always.
Mm-hmm.
It could be an astrological blockage. It could be a Vastu blockage. But what Vastu does, it aligns all your energies so you can get 100%. You get it? Like if you're putting 100% effort into something and like they say, the universe is helping you. That's how people say it nowadays, right? If all the energies are aligned. That's what we do with Vastu. We just align everything around you in such a way that you can reach there wherever you want to be. So I think Vastu is really important.
How would anyone even know that their house is not per Vastu?
If you want something in your life or things aren't working out for you, there is usually a problem in your house. And that's everybody's life. But that's because everybody's house has some Vastu defect or the other. Even the people that plan their house according to Vastu. And that defect is good because if your life is perfect, then, you know, like there were only... They say that when it's perfect, then it doesn't need to exist. Yeah. So giving you an example of perfect, there were only two places in history which are supposed to have perfect Vastu. One was Dwarka, you know, where Lord Krishna used to stay in Gujarat. And one was Lanka, where Ravan used to stay in Sri Lanka. These are the two places that were 100% Vastu compliant. And what happened to both of them? Lanka was burned down and Dwarka sank right after Krishna died, right? That's the story. So nothing should be perfect. Everybody's house has a Vastu defect. Only if things are bothering you too much, if your relationship's not working, even if you're trying a lot, if you're not getting there in your career, if your health is really bad in you, there is no way to solve it. Or if you're going through anxiety, you're going through depression, those kind of things where you're really trying and it's not working out, that's when you know there's a problem in your house. When we do Vastu, we kind of map your whole body, your mind around in your house, if you understand that. Like different parts of the house affect you in different ways. For example, the southwest would affect your relationships. Similarly, when a planet is...
I have to ask, sorry to interrupt. What do you mean by southwest affects us? So we do have southwest in all the houses, right?
Absolutely.
There will be a southwest.
Okay, let's talk about this. So if every area of the house affects some part of your mind, some part of your emotion. Get it? Mm-hmm. The land energies are such that that's what they affect you. That's how they affect you. So, for example, if somebody has a toilet in the southwest or even a kitchen in the southwest, they have relationship problems. If they have a kitchen, there's fire there, they will fight a lot. And I've seen this in so many cases I've done. People in the southwest that have toilets, their relationships are really bad or may end up in divorce, or notice it for yourself. Very, of course, there are some cases where it lasts and that's because naturally it got connected because of something else. So, you know, when they say that Vastu is very standard, when they say entry should be in the northeast and close your house, kitchen in the southeast. This, the absolute standard stuff doesn't work for everybody. Every person's house vastu is different. Everybody needs a different kind of a vastu. Yeah.
Oh.
So every part of the house affects you.
So I was thinking it's a very general thing. So it's not like that. So it's a case-to-case basis.
Mostly. There are some very standard rules, but vastu, yes. Like everybody's astrology chart is different. We were all born, there's still the nine planets, but everybody's astrology is different similarly.
If vastu is that important to all the houses, I'm sure real estate people also should be knowing about that, right? So is every constructor, every builder, are they following the rules?
Yeah, at least in my part of the world, most of the builders, the new apartment complexes that are coming up are supposedly vastu compliant. No, you forgot I'm an architect too. So most of my projects are vastu compliant houses, right? That's what I do basically. Yeah.
So let's say that someone has recently bought an apartment or a house or whatever. Okay. So they have invested all their savings or money in that property. They don't have any more money to do any remodeling or anything like that.
Yeah.
So in such cases, like the it has to be done. So how would you rectify the...
So like I said, we hardly make people do any sort of construction or breakage. Very, very rarely. Okay. Vastu can be rectified by putting wires inside your floor. And I get this question a lot, like, you know, there's already tiling done, there's flooring done. The joints of the tiles can be cut and we put the wire in and we put white cement. It's a half an hour job and it's done. And if a person doesn't want to get that done, either there are tapes that we can use. Obviously, that looks messy because people can see it. But different colors of tapes, we put bulbs, we can repaint the wall. There is so much that can be done. And how much will it cost? It'll cost you 10,000, 20,000 rupees. How much? That's it. And you're sorted. So, yeah, just go to the right consultant. That's the only rule.
So is yoga in any way connected with any of these things?
I think yoga is very healing for the mind. And when a person, when the astrology is fine, the vastu is fine for a person and they're still going through issues, there's a lot that's going on in their mind. Baggage that they're holding on from the past. When somebody has injuries on their body, for example, if they have an arm pain, maybe you won't know where it's, what thought they had once, which is stuck in their body, helping, fixing you emotionally. That's what all those memories in your body, also those pains. If you had a bad experience in a past, maybe you had an accident or something, the fear of that is stuck in your mind, in your body. So releasing those block, they're all block emotions, which is hurting something in your body. So it's releasing those blockages, those emotional issues. So a person with these issues will probably have a closed-in heart chakra. That's what I would help open. Yoga helps train your body and mind, cleaning out your energy, cleaning out your aura, the chi, the prana, whatever you may call it. So yeah, that's what yoga helps with. Just letting go of things, clearing your mind, clearing your body. That.
Can you give some like few tips to keep like what do I say, positive energy in the house?
I would say that, you know, if you're feeling bad or negative for a prolonged period of time when things aren't going right, try to change the position where you're sleeping. If your bed is in this corner of the room, change to the other corner, or change your office seat, the place you're staying in for long periods of hours. Try to change that position. See if life works out better for you. And of course, there's other vastu tips where they say clean your house with rock salt. Salt has the property of absorbing in energies around you. And you know, when people think that there's a lot of bad energy in the house, you start feeling it in yourself. So you just put salt around the house, sprinkle it, or you know, people mop the floor, put it in the mopping water and clean your house with that. That really helps, works wonders, cleaning the energy of the house. It just refreshes the house energy.
Aparna, thank you so much for taking time to talk to me. And we all had a terrible 2020. Hopefully 2021 would be a really, really a good year for all of us, everyone around the world. Wish you and your family a very happy new year.
Thank you, Deepa. Happy New Year to you too.
Thank you.